So you just got your new ViewBoard 50 series. Let's learn how to use it. So first off, you're gonna notice that all of your power control volume settings are over here on the far right. This blue button, this is the power button, and blue means on, red means off. If you wanna turn the board off, you actually just hold this down for about 5 to 6 seconds. That will power it off. You'll also notice that you have your volume buttons over here for volume up and down. And then you'll notice that there's this home button as well. We'll talk about what that home button does. Now your board does come with styluses. You'll see that I have a stylus right here, and these simply magnetize to the front. You'll notice there's little angles that show you where those pins go. Now what you're looking at here, this is called the ViewBoard OS. When the ViewBoard OS is on this screen, it's asking you to either log in or sign in using your My ViewBoard account, or you can just browse as a guest. What's important to remember is that if you sign in or log in, it saves your stuff, right? So it can sync your settings in your cloud and storage. If you log in with guest mode, anything you do gets wiped. It's kind of like a temporary account. Now, what's important to remember is that if you are going to use the sign-in, you need to go make a My ViewBoard account. We're not gonna go over how to do that now, but be sure to check out our other video on how to set up your own My ViewBoard account. So we're gonna click sign in here, and you're gonna notice that I can type in email, or if I use Google or Office 365, just click those links down there. You'll also notice that there is this QR code for what's called companion sign-in. We make an app called the My ViewBoard Companion app. This is something you can put on your phone, which just allows you to sign in a little faster so you're not messing with typing in any email or password. So let me pull out my phone and I will sign in with the Companion app here to get us started. And you'll see here, it's now logging me into my ViewBoard account. Now the home screen here, you're gonna see has a few apps already docked onto it. These are basically your defaults. So you'll see here, we have the My ViewBoard app. Manager is used kind of for IT management, Chromium for web browsing, and then Cloud Drive would let us connect, say, my OneDrive or my Google Drive. You'll see that you have some controls down here on the bottom right. For example, the little Wi-Fi bars let you know what Wi-Fi network you're connected to. You'll also notice that you have another volume control, so you don't have to press the physical buttons. You have a little volume slider, as well as this sun icon, which allows you to adjust the brightness of the board. Now you'll see there's a little light bulb with a heart here. This is just a getting started QR code. You can scan that, and there's just more pro tips on how to use your ViewBoard. Now I'm gonna step over here a little bit, and you'll see down here on the bottom left, there's a circle with an arrow inside of it. If I press that, it's just gonna show all the different inputs of the board. So for example, HDMI 1, USB-C. So if you connect other devices to the board and wanna use it, if you're not gonna use the ViewBoard OS, that's where you can access those, as well as, again, there's your brightness and your volume controls one more time. Now it's a little hard to see, but on the sides, there's gonna be these little arrows, okay? These are what we call the side toolbars. And you're gonna see, again, some familiar controls. So again, there's that home button, which is the same as the physical button down here. You'll also notice that there's these three squares. The three squares let you switch or move between apps. So if I'm using Chromium 1 second and I wanna switch to another app, I can come to my side toolbars, and then that's gonna let me go through my different programs. Now this four square one, this is important. If I press the four squares, that's gonna show all the installed apps that are on the board. So as an example, if I wanted to open up VCast, which is my casting tool, I can go there, touch VCast, and then it's going to open that app. Now, if I wanna get back to the home screen, this is where that home button comes into play. So if I press the home or the house, that's then gonna take me back to the home screen, or again, I can get the home button from the side toolbars. Let's open Chromium as an example. So if I open Chromium, now I can browse websites. So we'll just go up here to this search bar, we'll type in FET. Notice my keyboard automatically pops up for me, so it's ready to use. And now I can click through and use these. Now again, if I wanna get back to my home screen, all I have to do is press the home button. Now I'm back. If I wanna get back into Chromium, I can choose it here. Or again, I can go to my side toolbars. I can touch the three rectangles, and there's my recent apps, which is gonna let me switch back and forth. Now, you're also gonna notice in the side toolbar that there's this little toolbox looking icon. These are just some presentation tools that you might find helpful. For example, the freezer allows me to freeze the screen. So if I wanna lock whatever is up here, there's a spotlight tool, which lets me highlight on things. The timer is very popular, right? I can set a time and I can start, so it does a countdown. This can be moved around the screen, or if I tap, you'll notice that it just pops down there to the bottom, and I can continue working, say, on Chromium, and you'll notice the timer is still running at the bottom. Let's close our timer, and then let's come back to our home screen. Again, I'm gonna press the home button. And then let's quickly talk about the whiteboarding program. So you're gonna see this app here called My ViewBoard. My ViewBoard is your digital whiteboard. This is a great instructional tool. What you're gonna notice is that it automatically logged me into my ViewBoard account, because if you remember earlier, I signed in already, so I don't need to sign in a second time. This is what we call the canvas. If you touch, it's going to write. And the board is multi-touch, so you can have multiple students writing at the same time. The stylus is also great when you're writing. Instead of using your fingers, you'll notice the stylus also has a pointy tip on it. The pointy tip gives you a different color, so you'll notice that mine is orange. You can change all of your pen tools down here with this icon. This is called your pen tool. So if I wanted to change the color of my pointy tip, I just touch the pointy tip to the pen icon, and let's make it red. So now you'll notice that if I write with the pointy side, it's a red pen. If I want to change the thick side of the stylus, same thing. I just touch it with the thick side and I can choose, let's say, orange. So now the thick side is orange and the pointy side is red. Now next to the pen, you're going to have your eraser tool. The eraser just lets you erase. Notice it's not writing anymore. But because the board is multi-touch, it can detect the size of objects. So if I'm writing and I wanna erase, I don't actually have to select the eraser. Just make a big flat palm like this, and it's automatically going to activate the eraser for you. Now your board probably comes with one of these, just an eraser built in. If I use that, it does the same thing as using my hand. So a couple of these tools are really helpful to get you started. We also have some built-in templates for you. So down here in the bottom left, you're gonna see a little icon that looks like double mountains. These are your backgrounds. So if I open this, you'll see that there's some pre-built templates in here that I can choose from. So if you need a map, or maybe you need some lined paper, or maybe graph paper, maybe you coach sports, or you need a periodic table. All you need to do is select the background you want. It'll ask you if you want to apply it to all pages or just this page. I always recommend this page, so it's only one page in your presentation and not every page. Now, as soon as you need a new page, you'll notice that your piece of paper plus or new page button is right here. I didn't delete everything, I'm just on page two. And the way I know that is this little indicator here is showing me page two. If I need to go back to other pages, I can click on that and you'll see you get that PowerPoint type preview of all of your pages. Again, if I want to get back to my home screen, I can press the home button and now I'm back here and I can switch back to my browser if I'm showing a web page or a website, or I can use those side toolbars and get my double rectangles to quickly switch back and forth between those different apps. So this is how you get started with your ViewBoard. You have some accessories, you can log in, you can start using your web browser, start using whiteboard, and then you can use the side toolbars and some of those shortcuts to help you navigate. We hope you enjoy it, and be sure to watch additional videos so you can get deeper into how to use the My ViewBoard software, such as opening files from your cloud drive and saving and sharing your content.
Our ViewSonic certified trainers are excited to work with you. If you'd like to have someone on site or virtually guide you through a hands-on learning, please reach out to PDTeamUS@viewsonic.com.